Hi, guys. I'm sorry that I'm so sporadic coming on here, but it's just the way it is. This is how I'm feeling about today. So I have a quick break in my day. I'm trying to do school with the kids and kick them outside, but I want to talk about labels. So check your labels. If you're hopping on live, go ahead and let me know in the comments below. If you're watching the replay, you can let me know too. But I want to talk about checking your food labels. Now, I think this is something that we can almost get lazy with. Me speaking from experience, but then I think sometimes there's like times in our life where like we look at it. Personally, I think it is a challenge to do because we buy things in the grocery store and we almost know that there's things in it that we probably should not be eating every day, but we do it anyway because it's convenient, and it's harder to be more aware and being like, okay, this has added sugars in it, this has high fructose corn syrup in it, and I know that I shouldn't be eating it, but it's available and it's right there, so I'm going to do it anyways. So that's just kind of my feeling on it. Now, I just want to talk about sugars. For the month of September, I did a sugar elimination challenge where I just eliminated added sugars. So if it wasn't coming from the ground or had a mother, I eliminated it. I did even eliminate natural sugars. So like dates or not dates, but like maple syrup, just because it's so sweet, those kinds of things. But I just want to show you some common things where sugar, man-made sugars or added sugars, is very common in the foods that we eat today. So I'm going to grab a stool because I'm like at the wrong height. So places that are really important to check for added sugars. I have a child that has ADHD. It is genetic. He has the gene of ADHD, which he gets from his father. But sugars, added sugars, are not good for his brain. Any kid with ADHD is not good. Today's world is very hard because that's where it is. So I do not buy box cereal. I stopped buying it because of the added sugars. Except sometimes it's really nice to have a box of cereal. So I buy Cheerios is the one brand that I will buy. There is, if you look right here, it says total sugars and then it says added sugars. So of course this is a processed food. This is not from the ground. What? Hold on. So total sugars is 2 and added sugars is only 1 gram. So there's only 3 grams of sugar. So this is like a very low sugar cereal. And then you can go down and just see, okay, there's sugar. But the ingredients in a box of Cheerios is whole grain oats, cornstarch, sugar, salt, triple potassium phosphate, and vitamin E. And that's it. So, you know, there's less than 10 ingredients. So that's why I do this, because it's just, it is processed, but it's like a minimal process. So another sugar trigger is peanut butter. Guys, if you're not buying the all natural, even some all naturals add sugar. This is the Teddy brand we use. Dry roasted peanuts and salt. That's it. Okay, tell him to stay out of the pasture. Okay, well, tell him to stay out. He knows better. So peanut butters. Check your labels on your peanut butters. I have noticed, so these are a cracker brand I typically don't buy, but I just had a party for my mom, so I bought them. I typically buy Triscuit crackers because there's like 3 ingredients. There's no added sugars. This isn't bad though either. Total sugars is 1 gram and includes 1 gram of added sugar, which right here it says just sugar. But because, see the handful of ingredients, I just try, when I eat processed, I try to buy like less ingredients. And you guys, that doesn't mean like I like potato chips. I like ice cream. You know, I still eat those things, but I just don't eat them on the regular. My kids eat like crackers and cheese almost every day for lunch, so they have Triscuits. Another thing of added sugars is like sausages and meats. Make sure you're checking. This is kielbasa. I'm making sausage soup. This one I have does have 3 grams of sugar, and they use ingredients. Pork, beef, water, corn syrup, unfortunately, but it's here. They also use soy protein concentrate and, you know, monosodium glutamate, which is probably not the best. I don't eat this every day. It just happens to be what I like to put in my soup. So just check your labels. It's so important. One thing I noticed too, the local grocery store that I go in my area is called Hannaford's. Maybe you have a Hannaford's. If you do have a Hannaford's, drop in the comments below. So they have a rewards program where if you buy more of Hannaford brand products, you get like more rewards. I don't know why I can't say that word today. What I have noticed checking the labels, Hannaford brand breads, Hannaford brand English muffins, I can't think of anything else Hannaford brand right now, but those are the two that stick out to me because they're the things that I purchased no longer. They have high fructose corn syrup as the second ingredient in their English muffins, second or third ingredient in their breads, probably in some of their crackers too. But I'm not buying products that have high fructose corn syrup. It's a man-made sugar, and what it does is it makes your body crave more, and it reacts in your body and in your gut differently because it is a man-made product, and they put it in everything today. So you really have to be mindful of it, you guys, and it sucks because it's in everything, but there's no like regulations on this right now. And unfortunately the big food companies, they don't give a crap what they're putting in their food. They're going to put the cheapest ingredient, put it in everything. So they can make you sicker. So then you end up at the doctor more. Like really that's the whole big idea behind it. Right. So it's not that my kids don't ever have it. But I don't like it in their everyday foods because it makes them act crazy. That's my experience with it. And if you have a child with ADHD, anything like high fructose corn syrup, any increased added sugars like that are high, even if it's cane sugar, if it's like this first or second ingredient in something, I'm not doing it. And also dyes, like I ignore those too. So just be mindful. Like I said, it's hard. I wish I had something else to show you, but my cabinet is pretty sparse. Just be mindful. And that's all I'm going to say. Like, it's truly important to be mindful. If you're wondering how to make better choices and learning the education behind it, I'm going to encourage you. I'll put the link below to check out A Round of Faster Way and learn your macronutrients, understanding how many fats, proteins, carbs you need in a day, understanding that. Because once you understand that for yourself, not only will you get healthier from the inside out, your family does it as well. I have always been crazy, like health, but I'm just, you know, over the years, I've learned more. And now that I have a child that has these special significant needs, we're all getting healthier because of that. So I just think it's important to note that the food that you put in your body, there is such an effect on your behavior, on your health, your skin, all of that, your gut and how you behave. And I've just noticed it so much more because I've had my son with these needs and just noticing those little things. So if this was helpful for you, let me know in the comments below. Again, I will put that link for you so you can check out the Faster Way. There is another round. My coach is running one. She just started one this week, but you can hop in the next one. It's November, like a month from now. So you'll get it all in. Great information. Once you have this knowledge, you can't undo it. And you just every day you apply a little bit more, and it's just a wonderful thing. Have a great day. Peace.